Good afternoon, CDA community. I will be one of your hosts this afternoon. As you finish your most interesting school year, I'd like to invite you to take a look at how you've kept creative ideas, such as myself, alive during these strange new times. Let's start with a simple but beautiful rendition of artistic performance that demonstrates how humans are connected, even in silence.
Thank you. This year has definitely been full of challenges. Creativity and perseverance have been key ingredients for us to achieve our artistic goals. As humans, we have the innate ability to adapt and overcome whatever difficulties we encounter in our paths. In order to visualize the journey of life with its ups and downs, the middle school students have prepared a walkthrough of an expo they created just for you. Enjoy.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our middle school virtual exhibition of Beauty from the Ashes.
How often do we find ourselves thinking about the past or dwelling on it?
The past holds lessons. It teaches us things, but not only when we are aware of it and we act upon it.
This exhibition, Beauty from the Ashes, it's based on the rebirth like a phoenix.
Our struggles, concerns, or elements that we often dragging us down or away from what we could be.
The ride is just as important as the destination.
The artists in this exhibition started their process by writing down their struggles, and just like the phoenix, they rose from the ashes and made something beautiful out of it. The purpose of this artistic process was not to glorify the things that passed, but to set intentions for our future.
Our future holds dreams and hopes.
And if we underpass our past struggles, we can overcome them.
And in the progress of doing so, growing until we are ready to spread our golden wings and fly to the horizon.
The project room. In this project room, you will find the best art pieces made throughout the year by our middle school students. They are made with the different materials we explore.
Creativity is a skill that is fostered in all of our students. Art is meant to give a way to self-expression.
So freedom of choice is always allowed.
The visual arts are different way of communicating idea. We appreciate you stopping by and hope you enjoyed the exhibition.
I think a little bit by little, I'll be able to solve my problems and survive. Frida Kahlo.
Hello. It's very interesting seeing what people on your side of the screen are capable of. I love how art shows how people grow and always tells a story. Music can do the same, I hear. And I think I know just the song. It's a bit strange, but it tells a story I'm sure all of you can easily relate to.
Thank you. Hey! After that reflection on life as a whole, I'd like to take a moment to reflect on the importance of the fine arts in schools. I remember dreaming of the day I'd be old enough to join the band and the excitement when I finally got there and played my instrument for the first time. While I didn't exactly get along with all of my music teachers, their classes helped me make friends and taught me how to express myself in ways that didn't seem possible at the time. Things have been tough over the last year, but I'm very happy with all that we've learned and experienced together. To continue with our program, I've invited some amazing artists I know to talk about how important art is to them.
Hi, my name is Daniela Torres, and today I'm here to talk to you about the Fine Arts program. So, first of all, what are Fine Arts? Fine Arts can be divided into two categories. First, visual arts, that include sculpture, painting, and illustration. And then you have the performing arts, which are dance, music, and theater. Now, me being part of the Fine Arts program was a magnificent way of finding myself, of finding my own voice, and finding things that I like that I never thought I would like. And in general, fine arts are incredible because they are a way to develop your creativity. And creativity is a big part of both professional life and college life. Taking these classes is also important, not only for the creativity factor, but also the factor about confidence. Trust me when I say that performing arts especially can be a huge way of increasing your confidence. And especially in public speaking, having to stand up to a crowd and perform will help you not be afraid of having to talk in public like it happened to me, and that's why I'm able to talk to you guys right now. Something else I would like to add is that I know that in one day, art can be as something very difficult to pursue. However, I want to invite you to try it, because art is much more than just a simple song or a simple painting. Art carries meaning. Art can be a way of expressing ideas that maybe you can't express with words. You can make people listen, and for example in protest, you can use a song to help people feel something. And that's why I think this program and what it's done at CDA with music and art is extremely, extremely important, both in an academic, a personal, and a social environment. And so, with that said, I would like to invite you to join the Fine Arts program. I promise it's going to be really fun, and who knows, you might find something you never thought you would like.
The Fine Arts for me are both a way to escape reality and confront it. You see, it allows us to become pirates, say, or mighty warriors fighting for the glory of a great kingdom. And it lets us face with very real issues, such as the school shootings, the shortcomings of human rights, how certain groups are still marginalized. It's a way in which, when you are acting, you can be the most ridiculous and unrealistic character, and you can also be the greatest being that haunts us in our day-to-day lives, you know. And with the pandemic, this has allowed me to basically discover new ways to talk about myself and discover new ways to talk about the issues around them, about my life and the lives of others. It has also provided me with a way to escape away from reality, as I said, becoming a mighty pirate, or, well, just watching films that other people put.
Yo soy Diego Contreras, guitarrista, músico profesional. Pues bueno, para mí la educación musical en Guatemala es súper importante, ya que como ustedes saben, todos tenemos distintas habilidades, distintas inteligencias, y habemos muchos que desde chiquitos nos inclinamos más por los instrumentos, por el sonido. Y pues bueno, personalmente les diré que a mí desde chiquito la música me ayudó a enfocarme, a ser más disciplinado, a ser constante y a trabajar por lo que me gusta, hasta el punto de que hoy en día es mi profesión. En la pandemia también ha sido súper vital tener la música a mi lado, ya que puedo seguir cultivando lo que amo, y pues también desde un punto de vista receptor, También me ha ayudado a sobrellevar muchos de los problemas que conlleva el encierro. Y pues bueno, con la música nos expresamos, con la música también sanamos y con la música llegamos a ser mejores personas. Así que sigamos cultivando la música en las aulas de Guatemala.
Hola, ¿qué tal? Mi nombre es Eni Roland Hernández y soy artista visual guatemalteco y trabajo en gestión cultural. En este momento de pandemia es muy importante que nos cuidemos físicamente como mentalmente. Y en la parte mental es donde el arte es muy importante, porque al momento de tener expresiones artísticas y de hacer creaciones a través de ellas, podemos cuidar nuestra alma, nuestro espíritu y nuestra mente. Entonces, lo más importante también es mantener creando y tratando de inspirarnos a través del arte.
It's always great to hear from creative minds, but the show isn't over yet. Now let's check out what's been going on with the Middle School Performing Arts.
Maite López Aquino, most known as Jailhouse Lever Jackson, and today I'll be talking about the blues and the blues scale. So the blues are the base of a lot of music genres like jazz, like rock and roll, like rhythm and blues, etc. And I will tell you how the blues started. They started in the Mississippi Delta and they evolved from black work songs and gospel. So, who played the blues? Well, they were mostly farmers who at night went to juke joints or blues bars to play their music. And what makes blues so likable? Well, the gritty guitar solos, the harmonicas, and the soulful lyrics about life's hardship are part of what makes it so relatable. But what makes blues so special? Well, what makes them so special is all the genres they influenced. Like, as I said, they were the R&B, rock and roll, and jazz, among a lot more. Now, let's talk about the blues scale. The blues scale is a 6-note progression that sounds right at home in blues, rock, and country music. This scale is essentially the pentatonic scale plus one chromatic note, often called the blue note. This extra step gives the blues scale that unmistakably bluesy sound. The blues scale is formed of the following notes: A, C, D, D sharp, E, F, and G. Now, I did a song using only the notes from the blues scale, and I would like to share it with you. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye.
The blues characteristics are: although instrumental accompaniment is almost universal in the blues is mostly a vocal form, Blues songs are lyrical rather than narrative. The blues singers are expressing feelings instead of telling a story. The emotion expressed is mainly one of sadness or depression, often due to sad life experiences or problems in love. The blues scale's characteristics is that it's like a minor pentatonic scale with an additional chromatic passing tone. The blues scale can be rotated to begin on its second note. And the name of my composition is Daily Life. And I want to write about my life because it is joyful and sometimes peaceful.
And it was Central Park, an old lady was telling a story, half to herself and half to the others, who stopped to hear by. Many thought it was false, but the details made it seem true.
A long time ago, I knew a family that lived in a small cottage near Antigua. They had an only daughter who was 16. One day, the young lady was going to a party. It was late and she was tired, walking alone on an empty, or she thought so, Antigua street.
Good night, señorita.
Sorry, what? Who said that?
Oh, it's just me. I didn't mean to scare you. Don't let my height deceive you.
Hi. What are you doing here so late?
I could ask you the same question, but yet I don't.
I guess. I have to go home because I'm exhausted. Good night.
No, wait, please, don't leave.
Oh, what do you need? Please speak quickly. I really have to get home.
These streets can get really dangerous. Such a beautiful lady like you shouldn't be out in the streets alone. May I walk you home, fair señorita?
Sure, but make it fast. I'm extremely tired.
Such a pleasure to meet you. Hope we see each other again. Sleep well, Sylvia.
I watched him through my window as he left with his braid mules. I was having trouble sleeping, but my eyes were fine. I had a bad feeling about him, and his big hat and boots. Something wasn't right, and little did I know I was correct.
Yeah, how was the party? Did you have fun?
Yeah, it was great. But I met this really weird man on the way home. He was really short, like Napoleon, but instead of having an army, he had a sombrero. He was really nice. He even brought me home.
The sombrero?
Who?
Listen to me, muchachita. There's a lot of dangerous people out there, and that man is not the exception.
But Mom, why? I'm already 16. Plus, you told me I needed to find true love.
I just know it. From now on, you are not leaving this house unless you have my permission.
Juana came to my house. She needed someone to talk to about what had happened. And I had knew their family for a long time. I didn't believe her at first, but I should have.
Later that night...
Sylvia. Want to go on a walk?
How do you know my name? Now that I think about it, I never told you.
Oh, I just know. Anyway, enough chit-chat. Want to go on a walk? No one will know.
What? You know, I think I'll just stay home today.
Why? Are you too scared to be with me? I knew it. I just wanted a...
friend?
Exactly. I work as friends. No one will know. And no need to talk unless you want to.
Okay, but you have to promise you won't tell a soul.
I won't. I promise.
God, what tension. So, can I take you to your home today?
No, thank you. I'll ride alone.
Oh, okay. Bye then.
Wait, don't leave.
What do you need now?
I can leave you. You're special, at least to me.
Really?
Really, I don't lie. I never lie.
That's the nicest thing anyone has ever said to me.
Really? With a lady like you, so beautiful and sweet, I expected you to get them every 5 minutes.
Oh, well, I should leave now.
Bye, Señorita Silvia. What a nice lady.
The sombrerón was now going to her house every night. Silvia had big purple bags under her eyes because she was not sleeping, and her mom was starting to get worried. In fact, I was too, but I didn't dare to get the dear girl into trouble. She was obviously in love with this little troublemaker. And looking back, I might have witnessed a Guatemala Romeo and Juliet. The story wasn't much different. But instead, her death was real. My hair? It's braided? Mama, did I have my hair braided last night before going to bed?
No, mija. Now come to have breakfast. Your beans are getting cold.
Mom can't know about all these weird things happening. Oh, these are old photos. These photos are old. There's Dad in one. He died in the revolution of 1944. And the other is of Tia Rosalinda. She's also dead, and she's next to... what? No, it can't be. This can't be!
Mija, where are you? Ay, mija, I told you not to look at this cabinet. I told you that man was dangerous. Now go get breakfast. I will go to the market afterwards.
Mom, why didn't you tell me?
I wanted to scare you. Besides, you would be safer at home anyway.
Scared of him? Why?
Forget it. It's not important. Now, this is the third time I'll tell you to eat breakfast. You've been oddly full lately. That's not good for your health, mija.
Fine, Mom, but you owe me an explanation.
Bye, mija. See you soon. Please wash the dishes. Love you.
There's no time to waste. We have to go to my house. You look sad. I know what happened to you. Your mom left you. You feel alone. Our cottage is far, far away, and you won't have to worry about your mom anymore.
Yes, my love. Let's go. I don't want to see my mom ever again. What? I didn't say that. I didn't mean that. Can anyone hear me?
Ladies first.
Oh, thanks.
And Sombrerón plays his magic guitar so he can make Silvia go into a deep trance. Juana gets into a very quiet house, almost as if someone was missing.
Hi, mija, I'm home. You won't believe what I found at the market. Chicken! I can finally make your favorite caldo de pollo. Mija, mi amor, Silvia, Silvia, Silvia!
The next day, Juana came very sick to my house, asking if I had seen her daughter. I told her that at night, she had mounted a mule and left with a small man wearing a big hat. She came as pale as paper and ran out of my house. I followed her to see if I could help or calm her down, but nothing could have done anything. And looking back, I wish I did something. I could save her life. Where are we? What is this place? What have you brought me here? What are we doing here?
I need to open the door. She may still be alive.
Juana, wait, where are you going? Wait, Juana!
Ah, it's too late.
Once we came to her house, we saw the dead body of her daughter with purple bags under her eyes, a corny smile on her pale face, and a braid in her black hair. Juana cried for days until her eyes dried and her voice became rapid. The funeral was weeks later. Everyone was crying, but I heard a weak cry. A cry full of melancholy. And there he was. The queer man shed cried tears before disappearing in the dark. I never saw him again. I'm glad I never saw him again. And my dear Juana moved far away, dying just a couple of years later out of loneliness.
So kids, remember this and remember this clearly. If you see a short man with a sombrero and a guitar, run! Run for your lives and don't look back!
Okay, I'm excited to share with you the work we have been doing this year with the high school students. We explore, we experiment, and we create a lot of things in the art lab at the short class. I'm so happy we discover new technologies every day and constantly work on improving our skills, not just in the visual art field, but in the digital media as well. So let your senses take over and enjoy the following collage of amazing artwork and animation that we have prepared for you.
Everything mine.
Las mismas papas de todo el universo. Nuevas Spudies. Pruébalas ya.
Thank you.
every day and every night we'll be together. With the roof right over our heads, we'll share a shelter. Of my single bed, we'll share the same room, yeah. Put your
What beautiful art! Sometimes I wish I could experience the seasons as you do. I hope as you continue on your journey through life, you appreciate all the beauty around you. Good luck, and good night.